Many aspects influence evolution. Common ones are geographical isolation, reproductive isolation, and adaptive radiation, whereby groups of species evolve because of new environmental conditions.
Evidence of evolution, however great or small, surrounds us. It slaps us in the face. But survival is the key aspect to evolution. And other things play important roles in the evolution process. Habitat, geographical climate, heck, even fur color. However, one of evolution's greatest feats, most magnificent, most glorious, is the formation of Prudentia pincanus. And here, in the heart of the British Columbia jungles, we hope to find one in its common habitat, going about its glorious day. Known by the common names Pinky and Hammy due to its fluorescent pink fur, is a truly remarkable feat of nature. It belongs to the mammalian class, subclass Thera, and infraclass Metatheria. Very rare in its common wild habitat in the deepest parts of the British Columbia jungles, Pincanus exhibits the classical evolutionary properties of vertebrate life. The typical weight of the pincanus is much like its sibling species, rats and squirrels, of approximately 30 grams. However, not found as worldwide as its sibling species, rats and squirrels. Pincanus exudes common rodent characteristics. However, what makes it stand out is its truly special fuchsia pink. This extraordinary characteristic puzzles the scientific world. However, great amounts of research has been carried out by renowned professor of biology and behavioral ecologist at Harvard University, Dr. Jazium Ashofi. Pink elephant rat, Pinky, Hammy, Prudentia pincanus. What makes this mythical creature so special?
Prudentia pincanus was first discovered by myself while I was researching typical behavior patterns of ancient lagomorphs through my rabbit whisker buttons. I then spotted something pink in the bushes and decided to investigate.
Surprise, it looked like a pink rat with elephant-like ears. At that very moment, I knew my life would never be the same again.
Winning the Nobel Prize for discovering the pincanus was a momentous turning point in Dr. Ashofi's life.
So we talked all night about the rest of our lives.
Nevertheless, that was not enough for her. She needed to know more. In fact, she needed to know all that was to know about the Pinkalis. It almost consumed her. Extensive time and effort went into researching this unique and unusual creature. So I feel we're getting close. We have to be very quiet because the Rodentia Pinkalis is quite a shy animal. I think we found him. And there he is, sitting, basking in the glorious morning sun.
Pinkalis are very fond of cheese, which, funnily enough, I really do love cheese as well. Its firmness, its gentleness, reminds me of my ideal man. He should be tall, though. Cheese isn't generally tall. He should be muscular and fiercely ripped, but skin like a baby's behind. Eyes, piercing eyes. And hair you can run your fingers through.
For recreational purposes, Rodentia pinkalis enjoy a variety of activities. Some of them include long walks on the beach on a beautiful summer's day, frolicking in the park, and playing intense competitive sports.
I don't believe it. It is the mating call. This is truly miraculous. I do believe we are about to witness Rodentia pinkalis falling in love and about to begin the beautiful course that is mating. Gotta get some pictures of this. Alright. The institution of marriage in the world of the Pinkalis is a serious one. However, his so-called love of life seems to have old habits.
Days, nights were never cold. I had you in my life.
Heartbroken, the Pinkalis retreats to a place of seclusion to mend his battered soul.
I remember love warm as a summer day.
The only remedy in cheering up a heartbroken Pinkalis is a ridiculous rap done by two complete morons.
Yo, yo, yo! Feel the flavor! Feel the flavor! Yo, yo, yo!
Yeah, my homie here, his name is Hammy. And I think he's handy. Yeah!
Oh, yeah! Oh, yeah! You got flow, yo! His name is Pinky. He's really slinky. For a little dinky. Yo, check it. We was like chilling with Pinky, talking about all the fly
thingies. Yeah.
Then suddenly it got a little stinky, and I was like, "Oh, Pinky, was it you?
No,
you, you, gross."
Just kidding.
Pinky, you're so cool. You ain't no fool.
Yeah. You like the drool.
Oh yeah.
The complete moron's task was a success. Now the Pinkalis can journey on, being survivor, being fluorescent, being triumph.